Hello. You hear me?
Turn the situation to pick up two members.
That's correct.
That actually just happened.
And not only that, they're now going to get the Fire Giant Hero Bay. Cherryo on the left-hand side will try his best to split pushing just to soak up farm and provide pressure on the map elsewhere. But Obey don't look like they've got a sign of letting up yet. There's only two tier 2 towers remaining in this game.
Maniac even expended his TP to that T1 tower just to ensure that Cherryo could no longer stay split pushing there and trying to even farm, because he hasn't been able to get inside of his jungle at all since probably around the 16-minute mark.
And when you actually look at what Maniac's built on this Osiris as well, he went for the Pestilence, he wanted magical defense more than anything else, and the Winged Blade will help him out, as well as with the Vanguard to reduce that incoming damage a little bit more. That was all he really needed. That Winged Blade really helped him out when he proc to stop these slows connecting and slowing him down.
Well, when you have the Winged Blade proc coming through, and then on top of that you have the Terra ultimate, there's just so much mobility, and plus Osiris is passive whenever that decides to proc. I mean, it's such an issue to try and lock down for Valance right now.
And now he goes straight back to base, sells his Vanguard and picks up Mantle of Discord as well. So even more annoyance to try and deal with as time goes on here. A bit more protections for him as well. Gold Fury goes the way of Obey. They stretch their lead a little bit further now. It's up towards 15,000. And the tier 2 tower, the final tier 2 tower of Valance, remains.
This is going to be incredibly difficult for Valance to try and once again hold off Obey. And they really need a super strong Zeus ultimate, Susanna ultimate combination if they want to try and find any sort of comeback factor at this stage of the game. Because with the Terra sustain being online, and now especially with Fire Giant regen, if anything, it just becomes so incredibly difficult to try and prevent Obey from just sieging everything that they want. I mean, Valance have already forfeited map pressure entirely. They're not even really extending past where those T1 towers would have been on the map. They're just trying to push out the waves as much as possible to try and deter or slow down Obey when they're looking to siege up these Phoenixes.
And you talked about compositions as well. Obey's composition, the longer it goes towards late game, the more hyper carries they've got, especially with the Rama. Whereas Valance, well, we're getting towards late game, but they've not hit the late game themselves yet, and they don't have the greatest of late games either.
Well, at this point in time, it's not even just the Rom. They also now have to worry about a Sirkette. Sirkette at this point in the game is such a potent threat.
And now the siege begins. Right inside, Twig doing his best as per usual to keep one member of Valance busy, but Maniac's going to hit three with the Teva. Nice root coming out from Emil to follow that up, though, and Xalia forced to use the Lord of the Afterlife, which will force the beads out of one person onto Ataraxia. But now the collapse with Twig coming around the back too. Xalia's already dead. Next on the list is Cherryo. He's dead too. Twig gets that one. Now they fall back after getting the Phoenix and look for the right-hand side, but Ataraxia doesn't. He goes to the sky. He's going to make sure he gets some extra damage onto Fumballer, as now the Phoenix in the right is sieged.
And again, Ataraxia just having complete free reign with this ROM. Just nonstop, hold down that left click and put the gas pedal online. And he's got the sustain coming out from his team. He has his front line, and this Titan could be theirs.
There's the frenzy, 25% extra damage, and the burst you can see is huge. Ataraxia gets one, and they're looking for kills over killing the Titan, but the Titan will fall 2-0 to Obey. They beat Valance and Han Valance, their first loss of the spring split.
What on a well-played set by Obey. Their patience was absolutely phenomenal and really helped them to secure this clean set win today.
It's a really, really good performance from Obey. Valance, a lot of work to do after looking at that set, but to take you through that set, look at some of the plays and analyze it, we have Aggro and Tully standing by.
Thank you very much, Hindu. Here we are on the desk. Tully, that was I mean, we came into this day saying this set's going to be really good,
oh, yeah.
And it definitely did not disappoint. Obey really impressive with that 2-0 victory.
And this is going to put him in a tied position with Valence Squad. Yeah. Both of them sitting at 10 points at this point. 3-1-0 for Obey. They don't have a single loss, only one split. Whereas Valence Squad, they have that one loss now. So they're going to be struggling in order to get towards that master spot.
Well, they're going to be all right for at least the time being, still sitting in that three-way tie for first place. But let's take a look at game one. In particular, I want to see Ataraxia. He absolutely killed it. Played ROM in both games, but game one in particular was very slow paced, really Obey relying on their Hunter to carry them in the late game.
And it actually got contributed towards Emilzy finding that first blood onto Fun Baller, yep, Scotty to allow Ataraxia the early lane pressure that was basically unavoidable for Fun Baller. He didn't really have that good of a time after that first blood.
No, I mean, you saw how much damage even the Fafnir can do in that sort of scenario. The Guardian with the solo kill early on, which, like you mentioned, allowed Ataraxia to have a great game in game one. Let's take a look at the stats in game one and see exactly how it broke down. Like I mentioned, this is a very back and forth game. Both teams very, very close in kills, 9-5. Obey was in the lead, but this is a very similar what we're going to see in game two, Tolly. The structure damage, Valence was in this game, but they just never got that tower damage.
It was because of the fact that they had the triple Guardian double Hunter that couldn't get ahead. Now, if they were able to get a little bit of a lead in the early to mid game, then that double Hunter would absolutely melt those towers. But those team fights around the jungle was due to Obey's winning it because of Pretty Prime on the Zeus.
Yeah.
The area of control that he had was just too much really for Valence Squad to handle.
All of Obey had a great set overall. You can really point at any one of them and see who did really well.